In a cell, there are three groups of organelles, right? Single bound organelle, double bound, double membranous organelle, and some of the organelle without membrane. So today we are going to discuss endoplasmic reticulum, and endoplasmic reticulum is those of membrane which is going to bound by a single membrane. This is Dr. Pankaj Kumar, your mentor for current sessions. So in this session we will be talking about the structure of endoplasmic reticulum, their function and different forms, and of course we will also discuss about the signal hypothesis, that is one of the key things associated with the endoplasmic reticulum, right? So first let's talk about the structure, and I would like to draw your attention towards the diagram itself. You can see in the diagram there is a nucleus, and here is the outer membrane. So between the outer membrane and the plasma and the nuclear membrane, there is a network of tubules, and simultaneously they connect the membrane as well as the nuclear membrane. So both are connected with the help of a tube like structure. This is what we call endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, now there are certain components of endoplasmic reticulum, and what are the components? The components are the cisternae, the vesicles and the tubules. You see, cisternae, vesicles and tubules are the same component that is present in case of Golgi body, right? But for a change, in case of Golgi body, all these structures are organized together and forms a complex, but in case of ER, they don't form a complex, rather they are independent structure. Okay, so that is the only way in which we can differentiate the structure which is present in case of the Golgi body as well, right? Now let's talk about the types. There are two types, RER or rough endoplasmic reticulum, SER or smooth endoplasmic reticulum. If I talk about RER or rough endoplasmic reticulum, why they are rough? Due to presence of ribosome associated with them. And how the ribosomes are associated? The ribosomes are associated with the two things, one what we call riboforin 1 and riboforin 2. So these are the protein that helps in binding the ribosome to the ER. Okay, this is what we call riboforin. Okay, now this is more stable. Secondly, this consists of cisternae and vesicles, right? And they are primarily concerned with the protein synthesis. Now if you talk about SER or a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, in case of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, what happens that it is not associated with ribosome or any other organelle. Okay, they are less stable, and they are mainly consist of tubules. Mind it, in case of earlier we have cisternae and vesicle seen, but here it is mainly consist of tubules. Okay, and they are concerned with glycogen and lipid metabolism, right? Now let's talk about some of the modification that is usually find, right? And in competitive examination these are often asked. For instance, sacroplasmic reticulum, this is a type of endoplasmic reticulum that is found in muscles, and they are primarily concerned with the storage of calcium, okay, and that helps in the muscle contractions. Okay, then we have a ergastroplasm, right? They are small parallel cisternae of ER. The typical example is nasal granule that is found in the cyton of a nerve cell. This is what we call ergastroplasm. Then another is what we call myeloid bodies. Now what is myeloid bodies? These are smooth ER, right? And found in pigmented epithelial cells of the retina. Okay, so this is the myeloid. And one is microsome. Again, it is the pieces of ER, right, with associated ribosomal particles. So they are actually called as a microsome. Okay, now finally let's talk about the functions. What is the functions? The functions is the intracellular exchange. Okay, that means whatever the cell, whatever the component that is present in a cytoplasm, they can be distributed in and around. At the same time, they can also be taken from cytoplasm to the nucleus or nucleoplasm. So intracellular distribution is one of the main function of the endoplasmic reticulum. They also helps in synthesis. We know very well what they synthesize: the protein, the lipid, the nuclear membrane, lysosome, Golgi. So all these things actually helps in the synthesis. And another role is that they helps in the very process of detoxification. And how they do? The cytochrome P450 in ER, that is present in ER, is going to act as an enzyme, and that function in the detoxification of the drugs. So detoxification is also one of the important role of ER. Okay. Now we have one signal mechanism. Now what is signal mechanism? Now I would like to explain through some diagram. So in case of signal mechanism, what happens? This mechanism explain that how the newly formed protein get inserted into the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. So suppose if I draw this structure, let it be that a lumen of endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. And within the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum, what happens? That ribosomes are attached. So these are the two units of ribosome. Okay. And we know very well, within the ribosome the proteins are formed. There is a one structure. This structure is actually called as a riboforin. Okay. Now what happens? First of all, this protein binds to this riboforin. Okay. And as the protein grows, then what happens? This is actually inserted like this. Okay. And at one point of time they become inserted, completely inserted. Okay. So this is the structure. Now this is what we call as a secondary protein. So the mechanism by which this entire thing actually being inserted inside is actually called as a signal hypothesis, right? So this is all as far as the entire structure and function of endoplasmic reticulum is concerned, right? Thank you.